Hi, this is Adam with Movie Guy 365, and this week's blind buy picks are two movies that are connected to each other in kind of a shared world, but according to the directors, not a cinematic universe. If you're new to the channel, welcome. Please like and subscribe and share with your friends. I would greatly appreciate it. And this week we're going to talk about two films, Resolution and The Endless. Now, I belong to a couple of online groups. I frequent groups and webpages like Blu-ray.com, Talk Movies With Us, The Film Basement over on Facebook. And every once in a while, somebody will post a movie that I've never even heard of or really seen anything about it. And a couple weeks ago, this one came out, The Endless, which, take a look at that slipcover, it's actually pretty sick. It's got a nice little shine to it. And I really didn't know a lot going in, so I decided, hey, you know, one of the things I like to do as a movie collector is to take chances on new films. So I picked up The Endless, watched it. Very impressed with it. It was a very good story. It's not big budget by any means, but as long as you can tell a good story, put in some good location, have some good actors, and you can pretty much make gold out of it. And I thought The Endless was a great film. And it has a lot of supernatural type element to it. But then after watching the movie, I learned that it was actually not a sequel, but a spiritual follow-up to this one, which is Resolution. So I picked that up about a week or so later and did actually have a chance to watch it. And it's a very, very complex world that all these characters inhabit. And I want to talk a little bit about both films. So Resolution came out in 2012. I don't believe it actually had a theatrical release, but it did come out on Blu-ray, and it's a decent little film. The premise is that a friend of the main character, Michael, is kind of in a bad situation in a cabin out in the mountains. And apparently he's a drug abuser, and his friend wants to clean him up. So he goes out there, spends about a week chaining the guy to, you know, a pipe or something. And the two have like a great back and forth in a dialogue. But while these two things are happening, or while these two friends are together, weird things start happening in the cabin. It starts with like little things being left at, you know, under the stairs or in a cave or something. It's kind of like they follow this trail. And they start questioning what's happening, and, you know, it's and interacting with characters that would later be found in The Endless. So it's a very decent thriller. It's got a little very funny dialogue also. It's, you know, it's not a horror film. I would not call it a horror film at all. I would definitely throw it in as like a thriller comedy kind of thing, more thriller. But it's a fun movie. It's a little slow paced in some spots, but take in what you see, especially knowing that it pays off later in The Endless. And this is a world that gets set up here and flushed out even more so in the next movie. But it's the actors are very good. The setting is really cool. It's up in the mountain somewhere, and you know they're near a Native American reservation, and there's also like a subsect of drug dealers over on another side of the mountain, and it's a interesting thing. And considering the budget the movie was made with, it really looks well done, and I would highly recommend Resolution. So next we're going to go over The Endless and see how it connects. So as I mentioned before, I did see The Endless before I watching Resolution, And I don't really think it hurt my overall experience. In fact, I did go back and watch The Endless again just to see that connective tissue, and it's really very cool. But anyway, the premise of The Endless is two brothers that were members of this church death cult, several years later after they escaped, receive a video in the mail with one of their members, kind of beckoning them to come see them. And the one brother is like, no, I'm out. I don't want to go back. I don't want to do this. And the younger brother is like, oh, I want to go and have some closure. So reluctantly, they both go. And they get there, and nobody knows anything about the video. Things seem to be going okay. They don't seem as fanatical as they remembered. So they're kind of starting to have second thoughts about this cult. And then weird things start happening that pretty much is a mirror of what happened in Resolution. Messages being left for them, videos, whatever this thing is, certainly loves old VHS. It eventually climaxes into the ending, which is, it's a very cool premise. I don't want to spoil anything, so I'm not going to really say, but if you like a good thriller with a slightly slow burn, and I think a very good payoff, I would highly recommend The Endless. Also pick up Resolution, watch them both. They're good films. They're budget movies, but you know what? I would watch more movies from these guys. The director is Justin Benson, and the writer, Alan Moorhead, I believe, also co-directed at The Endless. Such a good pair of movies. It's not, according to the director, it's not a cinematic universe. It has a connection, not unlike a Stephen King series would. You have things that happen when one book are mentioned or happen in another or vice versa. It's definitely more of a Stephen King world, shared world, than a Marvel Cinematic Universe. That being said, I would love to see more from these guys. There is another film, I believe their first film, called Spring, which I have not watched yet, and I will definitely be picking that up and do a review on that as well. But these guys, they're a good team, and if you like a good thriller, I would say a little bit more sci-fi in The Endless than Resolution, especially near the climax of the film, definitely give these a try. They're great blind buys. They're relatively cheap. And if you can get The Endless with a slipcover, look at this thing. It's really awesome. Anyway, so that's going to do it for my review on The Endless and Resolution. I feel like I shouldn't go into more depth about it because I wouldn't want it to be spoiled, but they're great films. They're a lot of fun. It's definitely worth your time and money. Give them a try. So that's going to do it for Movie Guy 365. I am Adam. If you like the channel, please like, subscribe, share with your friends. I'm going to be putting out content daily. I greatly appreciate any kind of support you can give me. So until next time, this is Adam. I'll see you at the movies.